It is a hot, lazy summer afternoon, just the way I like it. Last day of June before July, and I am super excited. I couldn't ask for a better day. I call this a dog day afternoon, or the dog days of summer, the lazy days of summer. Whatever you want to call it, baby, it's yours. Hello world, I'm Miyah Ryan, and I'd like to welcome you to the latest episode of my blog series. So far, I've been able to share my own experiences on what it's like to live on the autistic spectrum. The second thing that I will do is give my two cents on autism in the media. The third area entails providing tips and advice for those of you who are on the spectrum, as well as your friends, family members, peers, mentors, educators, employers. And finally, I will cover topics on things that I'm passionate about, in addition to doing day-in-the-lifetime blogging. On my way to a movie, or it was a movie day at a friend's house, and I wanted to let you guys know that, first of all, I really enjoyed doing those day in the life type vlogs, and I really want those to continue. That said, it just takes a lot of work to take all of my footage and put it onto my computer at home. However, the first surprise is that I just ordered a brand new laptop, and that is going to be picked up sometime this week. And that laptop, hopefully I can download my software onto that little laptop that I'll be using at the school. And then I can just do vlogs and then edit them and put them on YouTube a lot quicker. And that makes me super happy. And then I have a second thing I want to talk about, is that I'm really excited about something that I'm going to be doing in the future. And I am going to surprise you when I do my trip to Savannah in August and September for Labor Day weekend, and I think you guys will be really excited about this too. So I think that will be great. And a third thing is, I'm looking at a brand new camera with better quality, even though I do want to use the iPhone because I like the time lapses and I like the quality picture on here and all that. And anyway, what I wanted to let you guys know is that I love doing my day in the life type vlogs, but I think it's okay if I do more vlogs right back home on the futon in my condo, because I have a lot of stories that I just enjoy telling you guys, and I want to share them with you. And they're going to be positive, some will be negative, and today I want to talk about something that happened to me back in January, February, which was right around Superbowl in Atlanta, and it happened on public transportation. So, as you guys know, there is the Me Too movement going on right now, and I wanted to talk about a Me Too story. So, back in at the end of January, early February, I met this guy. And no, he was too old for me, and I wasn't interested in dating him. I was more interested in networking with him, because networking is something that I really, really like to do with people. And turns out that this guy was in special ed, and he was going to grad school to become a counselor, and this guy was in his 60s, and he seemed like a cool guy. He was into Lord of the Rings and Star Trek, and he himself looked like Patrick Stewart from Star Trek The Next Generation, or also Professor X from the X-Men movies. And so we connected, and I was trying to see if I could get him networked with my other colleagues. So the first day I talked to him, I thought he was the coolest thing since sliced bread, and I wanted to share my inspiration with him and educate him about my vlogs and all that. However, I soon learned that this guy had an agenda, and the next day I was sitting on the bus listening to my headphones doing some meditation, and I felt somebody tap my foot like it was a kick, and I opened my eyes, and this guy was sitting right next to me, And so that was the red flag right there, and I was uncomfortable. And he had also seemed to be really nosy and asked me lots of questions, and I'm not going to go into every detail about that. And not only that, he started invading my space, and we started riding the train together. And I mean, it was fine at first, but he just started doing things slowly. And then the last time I saw him, ladies and gentlemen, I was sitting in the back of the bus, and he was sitting at the front with his friends. And so I waved at him, and then he came up and said hello. And the first thing he said to me was, "Did you miss me?" And I said, "No. Are you hiding from me?" "No." I said, "I like to sit up here because it's not so crowded." And then he said, "Well, the bus is crowded now." And then so he asked me how I was, and I told him that I've been a bad girl, not like sexual. And he goes, "No, I know you're a good girl." And so I knew that was another red flag. And then he just started asking me more questions that made me uncomfortable, like that one and that comment. And then when we got to the train station, he did a few things that really creeped me out. Like, first of all, he told me to wait till everybody else got off the bus. And then he started asking me if I was planning on staying in Atlanta. And I said yes. And I had told him the plans of my life, that my dream is to move to Midtown. And he gave me this laugh that was evil. And then he asked me, "What's with the short hair?" And I said, "I don't want to be like other women." And so we started walking up on the platform, and we just kept walking forward. And next thing you know, he grabs my waist, and he's standing to the left of me, and he puts his hand on the right side of my waist and tries to steer me into the train cars. "No, come on." And I was so uncomfortable, YouTube, that I said, "Actually, I'm gonna go." And I just decided at that point that it's not a good idea for me to network with him, because this guy had an agenda. He had a wedding ring on his finger, and this guy was in his 60s. I mean, handsome guy, interesting, intelligent, but he had an agenda. He was nosy. He was looking probably to put me in bed. He looked like some guy that could probably be abusive, because he was moving on me pretty fast and he was pretty controlling. So I got away from him, and I decided not to ride the same bus with him at the certain time. So I now ride the earlier bus to avoid him and to avoid any more trouble with this guy. Although I have a right to ride at that time, and I have a right to call the police. So, I mean, he's not the only guy that I've had Me Too moments with. I mean, I could tell you about more, but this is my first Me Too moment. So anyway, if you like what I'm doing, please be sure to subscribe to my channel, and also be sure to check me up on social media, WordPress. Until next time, I'm Miyah Ryan, and I'm signing off. Bye.